Hey guys, we got Poncho Sanchez here in the studio, me and Joy Sevilla, and we got a couple of callers who want to congratulate Poncho on his new model, and they can ask a couple of questions. So our first caller is Eric Perez.
Oh man. Oh, Poncho, first thing, like, I'm fanboying over here or whatever it is, man. I'm just still in awe that I'm talking to you right now.
Thank you.
Seriously, you changed the game for me. I was a big Giovanni fan because I was like the first thing that came up to me. But you changed my language. You changed the way I approach the drum. So first thing, it's a privilege and honor, man, to just talk to you and as well just congratulate you, man. I could see that set and it's beautiful. I think it fits your character so well. It's very open, very free, and so I want to congratulate you on a well-deserved series, man. And I'm excited to be a part of this journey with you, man.
All right, Eric, thank you very much.
So I wanted to ask you, like, man, like, how do you feel about having this set? Like, what do you like about it? What have you in this short period of time? Because you know it's been in the works and. How do you feel it respond to at least your character of playing and your feel? And I think how is it gonna go going forward in your playing? We're gonna see you on stage and performing using this series.
Well, thanks, Eric, for that. I'm really excited about the new Poncho Sanchez conga, the Brazilian mahogany, and of course with the Remo heads on them. First of all, the first thing Joe Sevilla brought him to my house. Francis shipped him to Joe's house, and Joe just lives down the hill from my house. So I was all excited when he was coming up the hill. I go, hurry up, get here. And as soon as he goes, Poncho, wait to see, they're really light. And I said, I like that right off the bat, because when you get old, you want the drum to be light, not heavy, no more. I lived that life for many years, carrying those heavy oak drums around. I did that whole thing. So when Joe pulled them out of the bag and I got one, I said, wow, they're light. He goes, I told you. So first of all, they're really light in weight. So I like that, it's easy. I mean, thank God, I don't carry my drums around no more. You know what I mean? I got a roadie, that sound guy who does everything for me. But once in a while I pick them up, you know, so I'm glad they're light, you know what I mean? And then and then I thought, well, you know, I hope they don't have a thin sound, because if they're light, sometimes the wood is too thin or the wood itself has a different response when you hit the drum, especially on outdoor gig, live outdoors, you can really start telling the difference there. You know, if the drum's gonna cut or not, if the sound man's gotta crank you up because they're just not cutting through, you know, all that stuff through experiences. Yeah. But I started playing and I said, wow, they have a big sound. You know, I was surprised because I mean, my number one favorite wood is ash. I'm an ash guy, I love ash drums. And I know Francis does too, but I wanted to try something different. You know what I mean, Eric? Because I have many ash drums, from Gombops. They made them for me, and of course my original skin on skin I got from Jay. They're ash and all that, right? Mm-hmm. So I tried them out, and man, I was pleasantly surprised. They got a lot of they got volume. You know, they got sound. You know. And
body too.
Yeah, and his body, you know, and I was checking all that out the first day as soon as Joe came up to the house, man. Let me check this out, you know. So I got really excited. It was only a couple of weeks ago. I've only had him for a couple of weeks, so I'm barely learning about him right now. But so far, man, I'm really happy with him because they got volume, they got sound, they got body, and they've surprised me. So they got some guts, man. You know what I mean? So I'm pretty happy.
Yeah, and they also look really good, you know, so that flare on the grain is just like it's not only does it sound good, it looks beautiful, right?
Yeah, I would say warm sound and warm look, you know, because they're warm, pretty warm look too, you know, and it's just the sound. So I mean, Brazilian mahogany is unique for sure,
you know. What's the conga player Javier from San Francisco?
Javier Cabanillas.
Javi. Javi, you know Javi, the conga player from San Francisco Bay Area?
Yeah.
I showed him a picture of him because we were together about 2 or 3 weeks ago. So I showed him the little video that Francis sent me. And he goes, wow, Poncho, those drums are beautiful, man. He goes, Poncho, you know what? Those drums, your new drums, he goes, they're the Tesla of congas. He goes, because they're so sleek and nice and new and fresh looking, you know? He goes, they're the Tesla of the congas. And I said, you know what? I like that, man.
And I think that fits it well because, you know, a question I did have is like, you know, because it is made from a wood that is really highly sought after. It's a wood that is exotic, beautiful, and has a very unique sound. So it's like, I know that this is a limited series too, right? So because of that wood selection, and it's kind of like, for the ones that are interested in getting it, there's a reason why, you know, that sound, like you said, like, why is it so unique? Why it is a Tesla, you know? Not, you know, it's like, you gotta get a Tesla to know how to experience it, you know, and to feel it. And I could tell, like, it's just gonna get better and better as time goes by. And
yeah. Javi hit it on the head. Javier hit it on the head with that one. I liked when he said that. But of course, in the future, we don't know where we're gonna go yet with it. But if things go the way we like, once he runs out of this wood, well, then there's other woods we can try out too. You know what I mean? So, but this is the big start, and we're real excited about it.
Oh man, I'm excited with you, man, and I'm also excited to see you play them on stage. And I'm glad that Joey didn't steal them from you, you know, because I probably would have.
And guess what? Eric has his set of Poncho Sanchez, so he's working on a couple of upcoming things too, eh?
Right.
Yes. Man, I was playing them on Saturday, man. I almost cried 4 times, bro. I was just like, what is this? Because I'm like you, Poncho. I'm a big Ash fan, man. It's like, you know, I'm so accustomed to that sound and accustomed to that feel. And like the one thing I think that just kept on coming to my mind while I was playing your set was, it's like the drum was EQ'd. Like, I didn't have to do much. I didn't have to. It's a beautiful sound. It's just, it did what I wanted to do, you know, and like talk to me back, you know. So
it's easy to play.
Yeah, man. So I know for you, it's just gonna be, you know, piece of cake, y'all.
Great. Well, thank you guys. It's nice to have Eric and Poncho talking on the phone like that. And
yeah, one day we'll meet in person. You know, I've never been face to face in person with Eric, but I see your videos you put up. You're doing a great job, Eric. Keep it up, man.
Oh man, I appreciate it, Poncho.
Gotta organize something, so Joe, make a couple phone calls.
Man, I still gotta visit Joey.
It's good to see you, brother.
All right, man. Likewise, bro. How you doing? Well, man.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Eric.
All right, thank you, guys. You guys have a great time. I'm gonna keep watching, y'all.
So we're here again in the studio with Poncho and Joey Sevilla. And I got a phone call from my good friend, Dave Perlowski. Dave is the guy who's writing all the content for our website, as well as super interesting articles. If you go to the blog section on the Moperk website, moperk.com, you go click on the blog section and read a lot of interesting histories, so it's there if you want to read it, and a couple of interesting stuff. So welcome, Dave.
All right. Well, Poncho, it is a pleasure to be here. And I just want to send my congratulations. This is an incredible relationship. It's been an incredible relationship since the beginning. And with us creating a signature series, I can't think of a better way to honor a great conguero such as yourself, and it comes back to us many times, and I'm just thrilled to be working with all of you. Francis and Joey, you guys are the top of the heap. But I do want to thank Eric for asking every single question I had in my mind. Every single question.
Yeah, he did pretty good, huh, Dave?
Yeah, he did. But the one thing that you said, Poncho, is with respect to the weight of the drum, and you and I are very similar in age, and I think I'm going to have to order me a set of those because my back is nowhere near, and I don't have the luxury of a roadie all the time. So, but
I think it's a good idea, Dave.
I'll tell you, the load-ins aren't too bad, but the load-outs, they're killer. How do you compare the sound? I mean, you talked to Eric a little bit about that, but how do you compare the sound between the mahogany and the ash?
Well, I'm still learning about them because I've only had them for a couple of weeks. So a few more weeks playing my gigs live, because that's where you can really tell when you perform live. Because, you know, you can practice all day long and it feels good, it sounds good, whatever. And then you get on the stage where the microphones are not quite, or the monitors aren't quite right. And then you got to dig inside you and say, I don't need no damn monitor, I'm going to play, you know. And then you start playing and you just get in. There's been gigs where my monitor didn't even work through the whole thing. And I was upset for the first 30 seconds. And after a while I said, well, in the old days, we never had monitors. So, and I made it through the gig, you know what I mean? So sometimes you gotta dig down and just say, I got it, let me do my thing, you know? So I still need to play a little bit more live dates with these drums. But what I've played so far on them, I'm very happy with them. And the difference is, I was surprised, this actually has a little bit of a brighter sound, which I didn't think it was gonna have a brighter sound. As a matter of fact, we were at Joey's the other day, and Francis put two side to side, and they were very similar, but I was surprised that the Brazilian mahogany, they were bright. They sounded really bright. I thought they were going to be a little more mellow or softer sounding, but they were just as bright as the ash, which surprised me.
That is surprising.
They got a pretty open sound. Huh?
Yeah, it's like open. I would say even a more open sound than the ash.
Yeah,
that surprised me.
That is. I never would have suspected that.
So in talking about that, well, if it's got a little bit of a brighter sound, and it comes out maybe a little easier to get out of the drum, well, now you don't have to work so hard. You see what I'm saying? So that will help you out. Or guys our age to say, man, I don't have to kill myself today to get a sound out of the drum. You know what I mean?
Well, the Mopurks tend to be that way anyway.
Yeah. We're spoiled. You're right.
If we can make it easier for ourselves, all the better.
Why not?
Hey, Francis, how much wood do you have in stock? How many sets do you think you can make of this in currently?
For sure, there's less than 100 drums we can make in Brazilian mahogany with the current stock we have. And as I say, sometimes it's really hard to say if any more wood is going to be available in the future.
Yeah.
Because you know where that, you know, Brazil is pretty far away. It's getting harder and harder to get such type of wood. So right now it's a unique opportunity to get Brazilian mahogany wood and Poncho's signature, or other models too, but you know, we're trying to keep the medium and lightest weight for Poncho's model right now, because we have pieces of mahogany that are much darker and much heavier. So we'll probably keep the heaviest wood for other, the Tropical series or whatever other models we make. And we're trying to keep the finest wood for Poncho's model signature.
I've got to believe that these will sell out very, very quickly. I fully intend to order a set for myself, for my back. But I see a huge demand for this line, and Poncho, thank you so much for lending your name to this and for being such a good partner.
Thank you, Dave, and it's an honor and a pleasure. I'm very proud of the fact when I first met Francis, he was scared in the woods, you know what I mean? Like, what am I gonna do, you know? But he, you know, I'm so proud of him because he took it step at a time and started working at it. And Joey, Sevilla, myself, we would talk to him. He'd call us sometimes and say, man, I've been working all day and long hours and, you know, ordering stuff and then the new machines coming into the shop. And now he's got a studio in there. I mean, I'm very proud of what Francis has done for Mopurk. And I know Michelle's got to be very proud of him.
You know, he has changed the Congo world. I truly believe that. And it began with Michelle, but right. To your point, Poncho, Francis has done a remarkable job in just elevating it to heights that, and I expect that to continue. And this is a great way for that to happen with this new signature line. But
well, you know, Dave, I could sum it up like this. I think Michelle, he picked the right guy to carry it on. You know what I mean?
Good point.
And that's a blessing because you could pick the wrong guy too. You know what I mean? And the thing could have went right down the tubes. You know? So I my hat's off to Michelle. He picked the right guy to run the company.
Looking forward to great things, and looks like Joey picked the right guy too.
Yeah, Joey's the one that led me there, man. Joey's the one that told me all about it.
Well, personally, all I can say is I'm a lucky person, and I'm blessed to have all you guys, Joey, Poncho, and Dave. I need people like that around me to support me and encourage me and, you know, give, you know, advices, you know, good advice. So, I mean, I can't ask more than have a team. It's a dream team I got here on the other side of the shop, because inside the shop we got, you know, I got Michael, my new shop manager, real good employees, real good workers. But outside of the shop, I also need to collaborate with artists and collaborators and friends. So I really feel like I'm in good hands with you guys.
Thank you. And the thing I got to say at this point is, it's time to order the Poncho Sanchez drums now.
Yeah.
Now's the time, right?
Yeah. Go to the online store. It's easy to find. There's drums in stock right away, right now.
That's where I'm heading. Thank you so much,
guys.
Thank you, Dave.
It is great to talk to you. Great to see you again. And you too. Everybody.
Thank you, Dave.
Thanks, Dave.
We'll see you.
We'll see you soon.
Bye. Talk to you soon.